lives. So we've entitled this series, this Christmas series, Peace on Earth. And I want us to understand what peace really is. Sometimes when we think about peace, we think of a nice day at the beach, and it's a perfect 75 degrees, and the wind is blowing, and the waves are crashing, and we think that's peace. So if that's our peace, then what we're asking God to do is to get us out of difficult circumstances and to put us in situations that are easy. But the Bible doesn't teach that peace is God picking you up out of your storm and putting you in an easy situation. Peace is called a fruit. Paul called peace one of the fruits of the Holy Spirit, meaning it's something that grows in your life. It's something that as you follow Jesus, the Holy Spirit produces in your life. The fruit of the Spirit simply is being more like Jesus Christ. And when we look at Jesus' life, he had peace throughout his life, but he went through some terrible storms. If you want to have peace in your life, if you want to be like Jesus, let me just tell you, this journey of being like Jesus is not just sitting back watching God make your life easy. This journey of following Jesus means you're going to walk into some difficult circumstances. In fact, God is going to call you and demand for you to walk through some things that are not easy. This teaching out there and this thinking out there that when you follow Jesus, everything's just going to line up for you simply is not true, because everything, according to the natural view, did not just line up for Jesus and become easy. I want to tell you what peace is. Peace does not mean that you won't walk through a storm, but here's what Jesus did. When Jesus walked through a storm, the storm did not take away his peace, but the peace in him took authority over the storm. He's in a boat. He's in the middle of a terrible storm with his disciples, and he's asleep. Everybody say, yay, Jesus. Because when I'm in a storm, I need somebody on my boat that's not scared. I need somebody on my boat that looks at a storm and says, I'll take a nap and come back later. Jesus did not let the storm get inside of him. His peace was so strong that he could stand up and say to the winds and the waves, peace, be still. And the winds and the waves ceased. You say, now, preacher, that's Jesus. Well, he said this. He said that he gives us authority to do what he did. In fact, he said we would do and are called to do even greater things than he did. So I believe God in this season, over this church family and everybody who will receive it, God wants to create an atmosphere of peace over us and within us that is so strong that we can walk into a storm and bring calm. That we can walk into a situation that we don't know what's going on, a situation that in times past would have freaked us out, but we can be calm and the peace in us overtake the storm. There are a lot of storms going on in the world today. You been watching? A lot of storms going on in our nation today. As the people of God, we are not called to freak out with everybody else. I'm just preaching this morning. I may get to these notes at some point, but I'm just laying it on you this morning. As the people of God, we are called to be different. As the people of God, we're called to be separate. Are you ready for some preaching this morning? If you are just like everybody else in your life that doesn't know Jesus, something's wrong. Don't say that to shame or condemn you. I don't say that to say you got to perform better. I'm saying this, there's more for you. Jesus offers you greater life than just being like everybody else. If you're freaking out like they're freaking out, Jesus offers you a deeper peace than you've ever experienced in your life. And that peace will not come because your circumstances calm down, because they won't. You ever tell people, well, when things slow down, we'll get together. You know what I've learned? They ain't slowing down. When things calm down, they're not calming down. What's got to calm down is what's in here. The peace has got to get in here and grow inside my heart and my mind and my spirit in such a way that everywhere I go, my peace is not threatened. I bring the peace of Jesus into situations and change atmospheres. Amen. Amen.